Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers. Welcome to the daily cricket show, Cricket Happenings. And on this Cricket Happenings show, Sunrisers Hyderabad had four wins in four matches. In fact, this was their fourth win in the Indian Premier League 2017, and they have kept their record absolutely intact. No team, no opposition has beaten them in the Indian Premier League, as Sunrisers Hyderabad won a game which probably went a bit close than expected, with the Delhi Daredevils really providing a lot of real fight there, as Sunrisers Hyderabad won the match by 15 runs. And we saw a wonderful innings of absolute finesse coming in from Kane Williamson, who was playing his first IPL game. In the past, he has played in a few IPL games, probably 6 or 8 matches, but he has not done anything of note. But here comes Kane Williamson getting his first opportunity. He has been cooling his heels in the dugout, and finally here comes Kane Williamson to play an innings of absolute class of 89 of 51 deliveries, 6 fours and 5 sixes, which actually won him the Man of the Match award in his very first stint in the Indian Premier League 2017. And the other news that I would like to talk about is, as you know, the Champions Trophy is coming up in the month of June, and this is the ICC Champions Trophy. This is the main event, one of the key events as far as international cricket is concerned, when the ICC Champions Trophy 2017 will be played in England in the month of June. And South Africa became the first team to actually name the squad. As far as they named, I think it was a 15-man squad that they named. And so I will be looking at the South African squad that has been named for the ICC Champions Trophy 2017. And but first, we are heading towards the Indian Premier League 2017. Rajiv Gandhi International Stadium, Uppal in Hyderabad. Sunrisers Hyderabad took on the Delhi Daredevils. The toss was won by Sunrisers Hyderabad, and Sunrisers Hyderabad actually batted first. Batting first, David Warner and Dhawan walked out to open, and in fact, it was the first wicket. In fact, that was a very big wicket. It was Chris Morris who actually provided, in fact, he was the best bowler today. He bowled superbly, and he was the one who actually got a bouncer, which was a slow bouncer. Which was done by Morris, and it was done very well by Morris. And David Warner was caught in the shot, and Mishra picked up the catch. So that was a big wicket for the Delhi Daredevils, as David Warner was sent packing for 4. And also after that, we saw Chris Morris and even Jayant Yadav, the right-arm off spinner, was also pressed into action by Zahid Khan, which is good to see. But one saw that it was not really helping, and then they reverted back to Chris Morris and Zahid Khan. Chris Morris and Zahid Khan, after David Warner's dismissal, it was Shikhar Dhawan and Kane Williamson at the crease. And Kane Williamson, as I said, was playing his first game of IPL 2017 along with Shikhar Dhawan. And both had to really be, the power play did not fetch a lot of runs. And also one saw that the pitch was a bit two-paced as well. And then Shikhar Dhawan and Kane Williamson took that turn. But after, once the power play was over, when Shikhar Dhawan and Kane Williamson had seen off the power play after Warner's dismissal, runs started coming, and Kane Williamson was getting runs thick and fast, but it was not with so many big strokes. We all know Kane Williamson, how he plays. He's a classy player, and the strokes were just coming in with absolute finesse. The way he was actually maneuvering the ball into the gaps and the way he was hitting sixes was a real treat to watch. It was a real exhibition of classy batting coming in, and we saw that Kane Williamson was doing that in an admirable manner. At the other end, Shikhar Dhawan was also giving him good company, and Shikhar Dhawan was also doing a good job playing some good strokes, and both were really, really pushing the score along at a very good rate, as they recovered from the big blow of David Warner to actually pile on a partnership of 136 runs for the second wicket, and finally at 136 runs were actually added by the pair of Shikhar Dhawan and Kane Williamson, which definitely proved to be something which really was responsible for Sunrisers Hyderabad reaching a total of 191 for 4 of their 20 overs. And then finally, the contribution from Shikhar Dhawan was Williamson who was out. He truly deserved a century, but he was done in by Morris. Morris taking his wicket after Williamson had cracked 89 of 51 balls with 6 fours and 5 sixes with consummate ease. Shikhar Dhawan, his contribution was 70 of 50 deliveries, 7 fours and 1 six. But even though Shikhar Dhawan and Kane Williamson did a good job of not only recovering from that big blow of Warner, one would have expected that they could have kept up the tempo. But I thought the Delhi Daredevils came in very well in the death overs and decided to, and they restricted the Sunrisers Hyderabad to 191 for 4. That was a good job because Yuvraj Singh failed to the bat. He was clean bowled by Morris for 3. 4 balls. Moises Andriquez was not out on 12 of 6 balls with 2 fours. Huda was not out on 9 of 4 balls with 1 6. And one would say that, you know, Sunrisers Hyderabad, after that partnership that they got, would have definitely been expected to score in excess of 200, which didn't happen. And they finished probably, one probably thought a 10 or 15 run short. But in the end, it really didn't matter as they were the ones who were the victors. So 191 for 4. Was posted by Sunrisers Hyderabad, and at the bowling, Jayant Yadav, seeing him for the first time in IPL 2017, 2 overs, none for 16. Morris was the pick of the bowlers, bowled splendidly, 4 overs, no made in 26 runs and 4 wickets. Zahid Khan, 4 overs for 37. Cummins, 4 overs for 37 as well. Matthews, 3 overs for 41. Angelo Matthews was really taken to the cleaners, and Kane Williamson really carved him from very nice boundaries. Amit Mishra also came in for some severe beating from the hand of Shikhar Dhawan and Kane Williamson. So 192 was the target for the Delhi Daredevils. So Delhi Daredevils got on to the chase, and Sam Billings and Samson opening the innings. And they had a surprise. They had Mohammad Siraj actually playing for the Sunrisers Hyderabad today. And Mohammad Siraj did not disappoint. Definitely, I wouldn't say this wicket, this particular ball truly deserved a wicket. It was not a good shot from Sam Billings on a ball which definitely probably could have been dispatched for a boundary. He was caught by Huda, the bowling of Mohammad Siraj, for 13. So Billings left 13 of 9 deliveries, 3 fours. Karun Nair and Sanju Samson basically took that time. And finally started unveiling some very, very good strokes. As we saw, Sanju Samson get into his stride very well. Karun Nair also hit one beautiful six. I thought it was the bowling of Rashid Khan, the spinner. And Karun Nair and Samson were really doing it well. They were getting the scoreboard ticking, and they were keeping the innings going. I mean, they were doing a good job as they added 71 runs for the second wicket, which was done very well, because they were going at a clip of probably 10 runs per over, which was pretty good going by any standards. But then it was Karun Nair, after doing a wonderful job, at least one could say that he at least got over his 20s, and he contributed something of note today with a good innings of 33 of 23 balls, 5 fours and 1 6. Being run out by the Shankar Yuvraj. Shankar was very sharp. In fact, he picked up the ball. I think it was in the deep. He was in the deep, and he actually relayed the throw with. It was a good throw, a pinpoint throw from V. Shankar, and Yuvraj Singh whipped off the bails. So 33 of 23 balls, 5 fours and 1 6. A good knock from Karun Nair, which will give him a lot of confidence. After that, Rishabh Pant came up the order, which was good to see. But Rishabh Pant disappointed as he tried to hit the very first ball that he received from Yuvraj Singh into the stands, and in the process perished as he holed out to David Warner, who was stationed there, especially for that biggie shot that Rishabh Pant has the tendency to play. And he was gone, caught Warner, bowled Yuvraj Singh for naught. So that made it 86 for 3. At the halfway mark, they had still have a good job to do, and Samson was there, and Samson was the big hope there, as we saw Shreyas Iyer coming in and join. Shreyas Iyer, the young Shreyas Iyer coming in and join Samson. But Samson, after doing making a good knock of 42 of 33 balls, 3 fours and 2 sixes left, getting out to the bowling of Mohammad Siraj, which made it 105 for 4 in the 14th over. And now they required 86 runs more to actually win the match. And that was basically, we'll say, 7 overs in which they had to, in 7 overs, they had to score. One could say that it was 86 runs in 7 overs. And especially they had to go at a clip of 12 runs per over. And when Sanju Samson was out, but there was still hope because Shreyas Iyer, and one was a bit surprised to see Angelo Matthews walk out when Sanju Samson fell, because one knows that Angelo Matthews has just recovered from the injury and he's just started playing. So one would have expected Chris Morris to come in, and that didn't happen. And I thought that was a big question mark. When we know that Chris Morris, what he has been doing in this IPL 2017 with his biffing that he has been doing, one would have definitely expected with such a score, and knowing that Angelo Matthews is just just playing his second game in this IPL 2017, I think Delhi Daredevils made a bit of a calculation error here, because Angelo Matthews was not really able to force the pace. But at the other end, Shreyas Iyer was doing a good job. He was playing some handsome strokes, and he also hit 2 beautiful sixes of the bowling of Rashid Khan. So Rashid Khan today was ineffective. In fact, this is the first match in the IPL that Rashid Khan could not pick up a wicket. 4 overs, none for 33 is bowling analysis. And Angelo Matthews and Shreyas Iyer had a job, and they were trying to do that. I mean, they definitely got them pretty close, no doubt about it. But what was missing was that Shreyas Iyer was doing his job, but Angelo Matthews could not really score very quickly, one could say. Even though you'll say that he scored 31 of 23 balls, 2 fours and 1 6, one would imagine that that would have been. And finally, the match came down to the wire with the last over, which was bowled by Siddharth Kaul. 24 runs were required for the Delhi Daredevils to win, and it was definitely a tough ask. But Siddharth Kaul's second ball was dispatched by Angelo Matthews into the spectators for a beautiful six. And that really started everyone sit up and start thinking as to what would happen. But nothing of that sort happened. In fact, Siddharth Kaul nailed his man, Angelo Matthews, in a wonderful manner as he got him caught by Jordan with the bowling of Kaul for 31 of 23 Delhi's, 2 fours and 1 six, leaving the enormous task. There was nothing. When Chris Morris walked down, he had nothing to do. All that he could do is watch from the non-strikers end as Shreyas Iyer finished on an unbeaten 50 of 31 deliveries, 5 fours and 2 sixes. The game was over, and Delhi Daredevils ended up with 176 for 5, falling short by 15 runs. And one really thought that there was definitely a bit of a calculation error on the part of the Delhi Daredevils not to send in Chris Morris, despite the fact that Angelo Matthews was only playing his second match. And one would have definitely expected, with so many runs to, I mean, almost 12 runs per over, one would have not expected Angelo Matthews to come. Probably it could have been Chris Morris. And look at this, Chris Morris, who really has the ability to hit it big, he has been, was left high and dry without facing a ball. And one does not know what was the reason. Probably it didn't click at the time. Probably thought that Angelo Matthews would be able to do it, but it was not. And I thought that was the one where the Delhi Daredevils missed one bit of a trick here. But nevertheless, they will learn from their mistakes, no doubt about it. One could probably, everyone learns from experience. So probably they expected something to happen, but one feels sorry to see that Chris Morris did not even face a single delivery, known for his big hitting, I would say. Bhuvneshwar Kumar, 4 overs, 29 runs, no wicket. Mohammad Siraj gave them the breakthrough, 4 overs, no made in 239. Siddharth Kaul, 1 for 32. Rashid Khan is at wicketless in the IPL, first IPL match after coming into this IPL 2017, none for 33. Andre Kes, 3 overs for 32. And Yuvraj Singh bowled 1 over, in which he got the important wicket of Rishabh Pant, who was definitely the big wicket, because Rishabh Pant can do immense damage, as you all know, to the bowlers. And Kane Williamson, for his innings of absolute finesse, taking over the man of the match. So let me not, and tomorrow the match which is coming out is between Mumbai Indians and Kingsland Punjab. And I can tell you one thing, that Mumbai Indians are really roaring very well in this Indian Premier League 2017 compared to previous years. So that should give them a real boost as they take on the Kingsland Punjab. And also Mumbai Indians have the newfound confidence. The form of Kieran Pollard and Rohit Sharma was a concern at the start of the IPL 2017, but they have really pulled up their socks very well, and they have started hitting their straps at the right time. So that is good news for Mumbai Indians. So Mumbai Indians taking on the Kings XI Punjab at the Holkar Stadium in Indore, which is known to be a sort of a graveyard as far as pace bowling is, as bowlers are concerned, because huge scores have been scored on that particular ground. So one would probably see some real big hitting coming up tomorrow at the Holkar Stadium in Indore, and that should be thorough entertainment. Now, before wasting any time, before I leave the cricket show, let me talk about the ICC Champions Trophy. As the ICC Champions Trophy 2017 is around the corner. It's coming up in the month of June. It's going to be played in the United Kingdom in England. And, well, the South Africa became the first team to actually name the ICC Champions Trophy squad, the 15-member squad. And the 15-member squad consists of AB de Villiers will captain the side, so that's good news. And then they have Hashim Amla and Quinton de Kock to open the innings. Duplessis, the experienced Duplessis, Dumini, another experienced bloke there, David Miller, Farhan Bahardeen, Chris Morris. Now, what South Africa have done in this ICC Champions Trophy, from what I can really gather here, is they have really stocked the team with lots of talented all-rounders. Chris Morris, Wayne Parnell, Andile Felicavayo, and also one can say Dwayne Pretorius. These are all four all-rounders, and I'm sure these four all-rounders would play a major role in the ICC Champions Trophy, because they can contribute with both bat and ball. The bowling, well, South Africa definitely are going to be missing the services, unfortunately, due to injuries. And that too, they are two key players, Dale Steyn and Vinon Philander, being left out due to injury, which is pretty sad. So Kagiso Rabada will be expected to man the main pace bowler duties. And then they have Moni Markel has come back, has hit the team. So that's good to know. Moni Markel is already in some good form, as we know, as to how he bowled in New Zealand. So that is also good news. The spin, it would be in the hands of Imran Tahir, who would be partnered. Keshav Maharaj, who has been doing very well. He did well on the New Zealand tour as well. And he has got the nod for this major tournament. So he'll be taking part in a major tournament for the first time, Keshav Maharaj. And so that is something. And Keshav Maharaj, the other advantage about Keshav Maharaj, is also a very good lower order batsman who can really start playing some strokes. So he was preferred to Tabrez Shamsi, the wrist spinner. So that is the composition of the squad. And South Africa, as you know, have always been let down. I mean, when it comes to any major tournament, marquee cup or marquee tournaments, we have seen that South Africa have really faltered at the final bend. So one has to see whether they can turn this Champions Trophy, their record in the in any major tournament round, by winning this ICC Champions Trophy, because they definitely know that this is something that they are looking out for. Well, as I said, but it's a good composition of the team, but definitely they are missing Dale Steyn and Vernon Philander due to injury, which is pretty sad. But I think overall, I think the South Africans are given a lot of emphasis on having some very good all-rounders. And I think that's a nice way to go, because on English wickets, I think Chris Morris, Wayne Parnell, Andile Felicavayo, and Dwayne Pretorius would like to, only they would like, they would like, they would get some movement. And besides, they are also handy batsmen. And also Keshav Maharaj, the spinner, you can also call him an all-rounder, because he is also a very good lower order hard-hitting batsman. I mean, a lower order batsman who could definitely bat. So definitely a very good team composition for South Africa, who became the first team to actually select the Champions Trophy squad here. Well, on this note, it's about time for me to end this cricket show today by saying a very good night to all my dear friends and subscribers. Thank you.